Hello and welcome back to our Sydney Proactive studio. I'm Karen Tan. We're about to cross to Canberra now to talk to Philippe Odouard, the Managing Director of the leading Australian Defence and Homeland Security company, XTEK Limited. Hi Philippe, how are you?
Good morning, Karen.
Now, a big strategic acquisition announced this week for XTEK, acquiring an American ballistic armour company. Can you tell us the details and how it came about?
Well, it's a very long story. We've been researching and doing a lot of development on ballistic armour, and we came up with a very good setup in terms of process. Which allows us to deliver up to 30% lighter armor for the same performance. So we are at the present time industrializing and commercializing that particular technology. And of course, you know, the US market was of great interest to us. It's the US market is the largest in the world. It's about half of the world market just on its own. However, the problem we have in the US is that you need to sort of be able to manufacture there. Otherwise, you know, they're not that interested. So we've been looking for solutions to that particular problem for a while, and knew we basically opportunistic got a phone call one day from that company HighCom, who you know was trying to sort of find a way to sort of develop and were not very strong in terms of new products, but had a very good presence commercially speaking on one side in the US, as well as a manufacturing capability. So we started discussing, and then you know we found out that the fit between our two organizations was exceptional. We have new products; they have really the access to the market. Together, we can do you know great things, and in particular address the military market in the U.S., which is huge, which is looking for much more advanced technology than what they had. And you know we had difficulties to sort of make sure we could manufacture that.
So Can I just ask, why are the products from this company of interest to you? And I believe it's body armor and protective equipment we're talking about. What sets it apart and makes it special and attracts your interest?
Well, it's not their products that attract our interest. We have the products. It's their capacity to sell in the US and to manufacture in the US, which they have. You know, their products are good, but not exceptional. Ours are much, much better than theirs. So the combination of having that manufacturing as well as the commercialization and our products makes it an extremely powerful proposition.
And what are the key terms and financial aspects of the agreement, and when will it be finalized?
So the key terms typically are we are exchanging shares typically. So the acquisition is done in terms of a lot of our shares to them, plus you know a bit of cash, a multiple of typically 2.6, which is you know very, very cheap if you look at it. But from the vendor's point of view, it's actually not that bad because they get a lot of our shares, and the synergies between the two companies being so high, they expect to make their money basically in the growth of the share of the combined organization. In terms of the closing, it's a question of typically 60 days or so. We are still due to sort of pass the different controls in the U.S. government between our two countries. It's not too bad, so it should be pretty quick. We've cleared a lot of the questions they already have, and you know it should be. We're talking September probably.
And do any more funds need to be raised? I understand there was an additional $1 million, or is that settled already?
So we've raised $2.7 million in the last 48 hours to a large extent. So we actually, you know, were oversubscribed. You know, the placement has been closed. We now are in the process of an SPP. We'd like to sort of give the opportunity to the people that have, you know, owned some of our shares for a long time to sort of catch up and not be diluted and participate into that capital raise. So this is opening now. Basically, the documentation will be sent on Monday and will be open for 2 weeks. So anyone that is a shareholder with us can actually subscribe to shares up to $15,000 at 45 cents in the next couple of weeks.
So following this acquisition, will there be any particular markets that your company will be targeting?
Well, of course, the US market is the biggest, but you know we will be in a position to sort of propose products as soon as our factory is actually running here in Australia with our machines and our products. So towards the end of the year, you know, we'll be selling in the US. The moment we start selling in the US, you know, the other markets are going to open up very quickly. We're already in contact with a lot of them in Europe in particular, first world countries that tend to value the weight savings that our products actually provide. And so we believe that a good go in the US is going to have a lot of repercussion in the rest of the world.
So how big is the market?
The market is actually huge. You know, the US have got 1.8 million soldiers on one side. They have 800,000 policemen. All of them are kitted in a way or another. Our technology allows you to make helmets as well as plates. And these people tend to wear a lot of those, you know, a lot of the time. So a saving of 30% is a huge advantage. Again, for a third world countries, probably less. I mean, they are more cost conscious. But first world countries, definitely, all of them have got a huge interest into this.
So XTEK has headquarters in Canberra. So will this US acquisition alter your operating strategy in any way?
No, it's completely part of our strategy. I mean, the problem we had was to try and find a way to sort of market in the biggest market in the world. We found that. And so, you know, it will really boost the company, you know, massively. So we believe that it's a great investment.
Well, congratulations on the acquisition and thanks for the update. And we look forward to hearing how it unfolds for the rest of the year as far as company news flow and other aspects of your company's operations.
Thank you, Karen.
Thanks, Philippe. That's Philippe Odouard from XTEK Limited.